sprint edition. Back again with another Champions League review. Gameweek 1 of the 21-22 Champions League kicked off. Fantastic gameweek. A couple of shocks in there. And the typical European results. But of course, before we move on, drop a like on the video as it helps the channel so much. Comment down below and of course subscribe. But match day one was absolutely hectic. It started off with Young Boys versus Manchester United. Manchester United thought it was going to be a routine win. Young Boys had other ideas. Manchester United had a man sent off. Of the game just completely changed. Young Boys attacked and were very successful and ended up winning the game 2-1. Goals from Ronaldo in the first half before the yellow card or the red card wasn't enough. Sevilla 1, Salzburg 1. An interesting game. I didn't watch it. Caught the highlights. Decent game. Kiev 0, Benfica 0, Barcelona 0, Bayern Munich 3. Bayern Munich absolutely destroyed Barcelona towards the end of the game. They were very good in the game, managing the game very well. I was very impressed with Bayern and how Nagelsmann sent the team out. I think Bayern are strong favourites this year. Villarreal 2, Atlanta. Seems like it was an entertaining game, a good game on all accounts. Lille 0, Wolfsburg 0, Malmo 0, Juventus 3, Chelsea 1, Zenit 0. Chelsea weren't impressive, but professional performance saw them through with the 3 points. Now, we do have to move on to Wednesday's fixtures, because Wednesday's fixtures were more interesting, should we say. Besiktas 1, Dortmund 2, Sheriff 2, Shakhtar Donetsk 0, Club Brugge 1, Paris Saint-Germain 1, PSG were underwhelming in parts. Man City 6, Leipzig 3. I did watch this game. It was an end-to-end. Man City, this is why I like watching Man City. They just give you an entertaining game every single time that you watch them. They can be boring at times, but in games like this, it's very open. Atletico 0, Porto 0. The game has finished, but yeah, didn't watch the game. I've not seen the highlights either. Atletico probably weren't at their best, but I don't know. I didn't watch the game. Liverpool 3, Milan 2. Liverpool came from behind. Milan were 2-1 up, I think it was, just before half time. Liverpool came through and won the game 3-2. Fantastic from Liverpool. Pretty sure that they need that as well going into their group. That is very tight, and they just need every win, every point that they can potentially get. Sporting 1, Ajax 5. It's a very strange result, because on paper they seem very even. Ajax just blew Sporting out of the water, it seems. And Inter 0, Real Madrid 1. Real Madrid coming away with the 3 points. A valuable win in a, well, it's not a tight group, but I guess it's just a group where you just want to pick up points. And Real Madrid have picked up points away from home as well, which is extremely important. lost. Very interesting, because that, you know, even with 10 minutes they had to go through. Of course, the games on Wednesday. I forgot to talk about the Dortmund game of it as well. Dortmund were decent. Of course, as an England fan and whatever, I was very impressed by Bellingham. Bellingham was just oozing. He scored a goal. He was oozing. He was doing his thing. I was very impressed by him. Of course, Haaland scored as well. He assisted Haaland. I was actually surprised that a Sheriff beat. They actually got points, because I've just noticed that, like, there's just been a whooping team or whatever. They've actually picked up points on the board, which is really good for them. And hopefully they can take that momentum and cause a couple of shocks in their group as well. The Man City game was crazy. That was mad. 9 goals, and I only caught a couple of them because I was watching other games. I was watching the PSG game because I wanted to see Messi and Mbappe and Neymar, but that only ended in a 1-1. A lot of games that happened this game week that were extremely interesting, and I think going into match day 2, I probably won't do a preview for that, but it's going to be interesting to see how the teams that played away from home do at home, because it seems like home advantage is coming back into play, and going away from home is actually daunting again. You actually need to go and earn your stripes. Playing away from home, as a lot of teams are finding out now. The Anfield crowd was absolutely rocking, by the way, for Liverpool. And I think it probably got them through the game. It got them through the first 15, because AC Milan were very, very poor in that. But yeah, like, Liverpool, 3 points on the board. I think Man United, the only team not to get 3 points from the English teams, which, again, it's only the first game, you know. Things can happen, but Man United need to get their boots on, their proper boots on, and need to start playing some good football, start actually getting results, because it could get very, very deep for them if they don't sort it out. Chelsea, professional, fantastic from them. The game wasn't great, but they won, and that's the most important thing. And City, of course, just doing their thing. Barcelona, impressive to me against Bayern. Bayern just swept them away. And those were basically the games that I did watch that I can't comment on. But if you did watch any of the games, let me know. Let me know your thoughts as well in the comments. And I'll catch you on the next video.